in this particular side of the road where traffic came through every day, and for his living, he begged and asked for assistance, and they gave it to him. Everybody in the community knew this man was on assistance from the community. Everybody got to give to him because he's blind. He's here every day. You see him. Everybody's familiar with this man. And then Jesus' disciples, they're not very saved. They don't know much about the teachings of Jesus. Just got on the team. Don't know a whole lot. But then here's a man with a maybe a good man, a bad thing happened to him. But a man for sure, something bad has happened to him. And how many have ever been around the question, has happened to you, or you know someone, something bad happened, something really bad? How did that happen to such a good person? How did they wind up in that circumstance, that situation? How did they, something must have, it must have messed up somewhere along the way. They're at fault, sin, or something got, I wonder what it was. Anybody ever play that trick on me? I wonder what it was, sure. I wonder what she'd be like. Something like that. So, this is what they're saying about this man. Why they're saying it's because we have the Levitical law, the jewelry system, that if you don't do it according to the way Moses laid it out, something bad is going to happen to you. And it's quite obvious. Look at this guy. He didn't even get out of the room. Or somebody missed it. Who was it? That's what Jesus' team members are asking. Questions like that. These days, 2012, Jesus' team, some of them won't ask that question. Wonder why they didn't get it. Why this guy broke? Why this guy poor? Wonder what's the circumstance? Wonder what he contributed to this situation. Before we pray for him.
Could this be part of the generational curse? I believe. Well, back then, the years you can have generational curses and those curses way back.
Maybe it could have happened that way because of granddaddy comes from the generation, somebody's done something. Maybe his mom was an alcoholic. Her sin is affecting him. Oh, cocaine baby. Crack-heated babies. Life dealt you a tough hand. Look at you. Come out of the womb and stuff. Whose fault is this? Why does this sin do this? Who would put this on? Should that even come into the equation? How does this bad, like a baby, bad things happen to good people. Disciples want to know why. Is that a legitimate question? People go on and find the answer. Is that a legitimate question? That baby is shaking in the baby. Undersized, underdeveloped. Life has dealt you a bad hand already. Alright. Verse 3. Someone read that.
Jesus answered, neither hath this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest.
All right. Jesus answered. We'll take his answer to be the correct answer. Nobody has what? Sin. Nobody. Not his parents. But, we're going to work the works of God. He's not blind so that God can do the work. You didn't get sick so that God can heal you. People don't get sick. God don't like to get sick, get whatever, so that he can do his work. You can thank your dad. Also next to that. It says nobody. But it's time to do.
So I think it's very interesting is that Jesus kind of comes along and there's a person there that he's able to do his work.
He's able to do opportunity time.
Yeah.
I think sin always is in the world. Man was born in sin. And so the effects of sin is there, and it's just an opportunity. Jesus just saw that opportunity.
It's time to do the work. It's a big question, because a lot of people get tripped up when it's time. When is the time to do the work? Where do you go to do the work? And is everything set for do the work? So here's Jesus on his ministry work, and he's been walking. He won't walk around where? Galilee, Judea, because folks don't like him. So he's out walking, walks by this guy, and he sees his condition. The disciples ask a stupid question. Let's get this guy's business. Jesus says, we're not into that. It's opportunity time to do the work.
That's something for us to think about. We're walking on the street, or running on the street, our opportunity to come to witness for someone.
Strange enough, as we get further into this lesson, Jesus said there won't be an opportunity like this all the time. There won't be an opportunity like this all the time. Not for me. My time to do my work for God to work through me is flourishing. Here's a perfect opportunity for me to make God work for me. We need to take that on our own shoulders and say, this is a perfect opportunity for God to work for me, because I don't have a lot of time. Me neither. We only got about 20 years. I should be able to get this another time.
I understand.
Some folks, and even in today's time, you can't use the name of Jesus unless you're full of the Holy Ghost, speak in tongues, wear long dresses, dress in black, go to church every day, all type of stuff. For the work of God. Okay. Here we go. Just read the word, brother. Alright, so Jesus says, but that the works of God should be manifested in him. Verse 4, as I was speaking of, I must work the works of him that sent me while it is what?
Day.
While it is day, the night cometh when no man can what?
Work.
Now, I'm going to say, let's put a twofold prophecy on this. When no man can work. There will be a time when there will not be Christian work, ministry work, can't be done on the earth. Jesus' life, night cometh when he could not work. And when was that night hour? When did that night come that Jesus could not touch a person, get him healed? Get him delivered. Was there a time in his earth walk that he could not do that in his existence? That he could not. I can't remember.
Before he was baptized. He gave up.
Say it.
He gave up.
He was gone.
The sins of the world was laid upon him.
Sins upon that what? Cross. Come down, save yourself. So be who you say you are, come down. Save yourself. He knew that day was approaching. So he didn't. Jesus saved him. So this is what he's saying here. I got to do as much as I can while it is opportune, while it is day. While it is day, I got to get my work done. The night coming, and he's saying it's going to come. When I can't work, and who else? Nobody else is going to do the work. That's it. Him, that's it. Nobody else. Personally, I don't want to be around. It's coming up. Okay, so he says, now here's another key, a nugget. As long as I am in the world, I am the what?
Light
of the world. Now, what he meant by that is that I'm the good deliverer. I'm the good news. I make the difference. I even the score up. I put you ahead. I bring in the good stuff. As long as I am what? In the world. As long as I'm down here in this system, I'm the one that brings the clarity. I am the light of the world. And the first light that people need to understand is that I'm the difference maker. Jesus, I'm the difference maker. We got a man that's blind, can't see nothing. All he is able to do is what? Hear. Faith come by word.
Hear.
Can't see nothing. But every day he's sitting on the roadside there, and Jesus' crowd of people, his audience is following Jesus, is following along with Jesus, his disciples is talking, and they're saying, man, he did this, that, he did this over there. Wow, he walked through Galilee, man, he'll come stop at a guy's house, whoa, talk to him, whoa, this guy is sitting there. I said, where is he? And that's all he is hearing the good news, the difference that this man named Jesus is making. Now, I want to say, is this guy a believer? He's wrapped up in the law of Moses, and they get wrapped up. The guy that needs the healing. He is totally, I can show you here a little bit. He's totally wrapped up in the law of Moses. Show enough Jew. Just can't see. He's a devil. Everybody else is all wrapped up in the law of Leviticus. I said the law of Moses. Can't do anything outside of that. Stuck in that path. Long dresses, black coats, all that. Verse 6. I won't be bothered. Hey, somebody up there.
When he had thus spoken, he sat on the ground and made clay of the spit, and he anointed the eyes of the blind man with clay.
Okay, verse 7.
And said unto him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which is by interpretation sent. Mm-hmm. And he went his way, therefore, and washed, and came seeing.
Okay. All right, two things here. Jesus, he had spoken. What did he say? Anybody got an idea what he said? Is it indicated in Scripture what he said to the man? When he had thus spoken, before he spit on the ground. Works of God is going to get manifested today. It's a good time to get it done. Man, know God is good. Okay. Sat on the ground, made clay. So if the doctor tell you to do something kind of weird, like walk 2 miles a day. Buy you some shoes. And then the doctor prayed on your stuff, and then told you, sent you out to go walk. How many were going to do that walk? Until you got into it. Until you could breathe. And your lungs got... Oh, y'all. So still, I'm in. I'm in. He said, go walk 5 miles a day until you start breathing right. So you start breathing right, you come in here and your blood pressure is just fighting. You need some exercise. Here, I got some shoes, here's some exercise clothes, here's a walking track, you know, 5 miles a day. Don't stop until you get 5 miles. I mean, now I'm going to have to sweat all this. So Jesus reached out in the mud, spit on it, put it on this guy's face, and go wash over there again. Most of the Christian world that we won't follow this plan. wonder why they don't get healed. Like, well.
A lot of times because it seems it's so simple. It seems like, you know, spit, play, you know, girl wash.
Go wash.
That is not, you know, sanitary, you know. So a lot of times we don't walk because we have reason ourselves.
So he said, the key word here is verse 7, sent. Sent. Shalom means sent. Sent. Sent means I got confidence, I got faith enough to do what you told me to do.
The main reason most people want to do that and go walk the line up is because they have a body to the belief system that doesn't work.
I don't know this man. All I've been hearing stuff about him, and he did something kind of strange, gave him some shoes, and he told me to go walk. And I have a little person about to knock the roof off, he told me to go walk. And the guy said, here I go. Or he could walk. So I can't even get there, I'm blind. I expect me to go find a pool. Blind. Buy into it, you'll figure out what a way. That's what the guy did. He figured it out. He says, he sent, so sent, sent. That's what we are. We are also sent. If we buy in, we'll figure out a way how to go visit who, or do the ministry work, whatever we're called for. I got a whole bunch of other stuff going on in my life, but you'll figure out a way to be sent. That's what this guy did. Okay, I'm buying into it. Sent. He went his way, therefore, and washed, and he came back seeing. And see, when Jesus is telling to the man right now, I am the light of the world. I'm your better way to make it out there. I'm your better way. So, the man don't know Jesus. Matter of fact, he couldn't give a description of Jesus to the people. What does he look like? How tall is he? Who? The name that you're talking about, the man named Jesus, who is he? And they asked him this four times. They interrogated this guy four times as to, how did you, who did, where, you said what, on what day, what? And now here's reality. I'm the same guy that's there on the curve that you came by giving me assistance earlier. I'm the same guy. Blind as a bat. Look at me now. I'm healed. People can't, you know, they still get tripped up when they see what? Miracles. When they see deliverance. Travis got some demons out sometimes. You can't come off that stuff just like that. You know? You got a ball with some of those. That's how it's up.
That's what your friend said.
Yeah, you just can't get saved. What is saved? You just can't.
We'll come back next week.
You just can't get saved. You know? Then make a bet. Oh, yeah, we'll bet. Make a wage.
He'll be back.
How did you just follow the instructions? Somewhere he's going to walk in the water. Read that and sort of follow the directions. They say, what do you do? Church story too. So,
I'm blind, I want to know how you get there.
So, Now, you're blind and asked him a stupid question. He's blind. And he got his sight. And he went to the pool. Well, he went to the pool, got away from Jesus, went to the pool, didn't want to do, got his sight. The next thing they asked him is, well, where is Jesus? And God says, how am I supposed to know where he is? I don't even know what he looked like. I met him, I was blind. I walked to the pool blind, washed, saw my sight, got my sight back, and going about my business, and you want to ask me where he is? You know, I don't see that good now. So, what does it look like? I don't know. All I know is that I got through it. I did what he told me to do. And the key is here is that do what he tells you to do, and you'll come out all right. So they want to know, Brother Rock, how is that? How is it that you like the Bible so much now? Explain that to me. Jesus is enough to get a difference in their life, a real difference in their life, they will figure out some more stuff. See, we try and beat them up and figure it out, clean them up. They got Jesus. They got touch. They coming in. They're going to figure out how to get there. Go to a church. Go find you a good word church. That's not hard to do. Go find you a church to get in. Yeah, people will find a church to get in if they got touched by Jesus. They'll find a church. How many up and down this street? Yeah, they'll find a church. Okay, there we go. Let's see how we can dig into this, okay? They said, where is he? Verse 5. I don't know. They brought him to the Baptist preacher. Presbyterian, the Catholic preacher, because you know, your family was Presbyterian, that was raised Baptist. So I mean you need to go figure this out. How you got healed? How you got, we gotta figure out how you got drugs. So they brought him to the religious establishment. They're going to figure this out. They brought to the Pharisees him that once before was blind. And it was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the clay. So that ain't a real preacher. I'll tell you that right now. Out in the parking lot, he prayed for me. That dog, I don't have one. Out in the nightclub parking lot, some characters come along with Jesus shirts on, and they prayed for you, and you think you got touched. No, you got to go to them. Come on, we got to open up the doors of the church. You got to stand by. You got to call them. You got to get back. You got to get along. Now we know you got saved. It was the seventh day. Jesus, and they brought him to the people who hated Jesus the most, the religious order. And then again, they're going to ask him again, verse 15, how he had received his sight. Surely you've got to know this. Now, I was looking in St. John, I know it was 9, and this is an so make sure we cover this before we end this. Look at verse 9 and 30. Because there's still a question throughout St. John the 9th chapter. This ordeal is still going on. Now this is what the man said. Look at verse 28. And I'm going to jump a little bit further because they keep asking him, Look at verse 25. He answered and said, whether he be a sinner, I know not. The guy who healed you, was he a sinner? I don't know. All I know, his name is Jesus. And I did what he told me to do. One thing I know, that whereas I was blind, what? Now I see. Okay. All right. Is that preacher over there any good for you, Travis? Is he a good preacher? Oh, is it, what about his personal life? What about, does he beat his wife? Does he Travis, I don't know. All I know is he preached about Jesus one day, and I bought it one Easter Sunday. And then, have you ever met Christ before you? I ain't never met him before. All I know, he preached about Jesus, and I bought what he was preaching. Well, now, what school did he go to? I don't know. I don't know. You know where you live? You know what Pastor Hill lived at the time? I don't know. I don't know. All I bought was who? Did you buy the preacher or did you buy the Jesus message?
I bought the Jesus message.
Because he brought it to you. Because the way you got it.
Yeah, because Paul that.
Yeah, Paul.
You know,
yeah.
It worked on her. I said, yeah. You know, let me go see what's, go see what's going on.
So, between Paul that and Pastor Hill, you bought Jesus.
I had evidence.
He bought Jesus. Well, I'm about to preach. What school are you going to? Where you live? This is what? That's what they're asking this man. He said, I don't know. Then verse 26, then said they to him again, what did he to thee? How did he do it? He answered them, I have told you already. and you didn't hear it. Yeah, are you going to hear now if I tell you again? Will you also be his what?
Disciples.
Then they what? They talk. Anybody talk about you? Can't nobody say anything. Yeah. Even reviled him. So you saved now. So you preaching now. That's what they're saying here in this verse. What's that? 28. So now you a preacher, huh? Now you can preach to us. Man, if you can't preach to us, I go to denomination so and so First Church on the corner. What's happening? That's what they tell me. I go to Moses Church. You can't tell me nothing. You went up there and got saved, delivered, and all that. You went to the Holy Ghost. All right, you're going to come out and tell us something. No, we go to Baptist church. Nobody ever heard. we got all of them. So, we know that God spake unto Moses. That's for this fellow. We don't not know where he is from. So they went back into the law. God spoke to Moses. And the man said something, and I'm trying to get there. Okay, verse 30 and 31. I want to say, is the man correct or wrong? Someone read that. You know, whoever read it, got to respond. Was the man yes? Correct? Yes or no? Who going to step up to the plate? Okay.
The man answered, now that is remarkable. You don't know where he comes from. We know that God does not listen to sinners. He listens to the godly man, but that's his will.
Okay, I read the King James. Most of us got King James. Verse 31 in particular. Now we know that God cared not sinners. Who said that? The man that got what? Healed. Okay. If any man be a worshiper of God and do his will, him he what? Here. Is the man right or wrong? Verse 31. Is he right or wrong?
He's wrong.
He's wrong. How many say he's wrong?
Oh.
Yeah. How many say he's wrong? He's wrong. A lot of times in my early Christian walk, I thought the man was wrong. I actually took it from Jesus. Jesus didn't say that. That man said it. But it's in the Bible. So it must be right. No, that's where we make an error. Not the Bible, the Bible, the word of truth. Just because it's in the Bible doesn't make has to be recorded. So, and then who said it? The blind man said it, who was a sinner who got delivered from his blindness. So he's back into the law again and saying, and you got to go through certain steps. Wait a minute, I ain't go through nothing. Wait a minute. He's twisted up. He was doing okay for a while, but all I know is the man's name Jesus, and I bought him this thing. Now he comes to explain it, and it's not taught. He's young in the Lord, he's not taught. He's not ready to preach yet. So he tries to give it out there, and he puts out some bad data. God, but only here. We got to be a worship. What do you know about worship? I know it's a good one. And that was broke to get him delivered. So get out of here. So watch it. All we have to do is present and say, oh, to Jesus, to the lost, to the sick, to the free, to the downtrodden. All you got to say, oh, this is what Jesus will do for you. And if I'm anointed and care a lot, I know enough, I can tell you what Jesus said, and you go do it. And you'll be healed. Like you'll be delivered. You'll be saved. That's all I got.
If you know what he had been taught, mm-hmm. it says a lot to us on how we teach our children.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, that's what he had been taught.
That's what he does. That's all he do. Yes, sir.
We teach our children.
Yeah. He's trying to rationalize it in his mind. He said, he must have been from God. Which is, yeah, he must have been from God. Nobody can do that with somebody from God. So he gives credit where credit is due. But he can't explain it. I can't explain it. Can't rationalize it. Okay, let's finish out the lesson. This one is eventually covered. Verse 14 of our lesson, St. John 9:14. It was the Sabbath day when Jesus made the clay, opened his eyes. The Pharisees again asked him, how do you see sight? He said unto him, he put clay upon my eyes, I washed, and you see. Therefore, some of the Pharisees, this man is not of God, because he keepeth not the what? Sabbath. He ain't so that he's disqualified. That's what the law would get you. Others said, how can a man that is a sinner do such what? Miracles. Wow. Got some tough questions here. And there was a what? Division among them. So first they ascribe Jesus as a sinner. Why is he a sinner? Because he doesn't follow the law. And 17, they say, it's a blind man, what you got to say? And he said, he opened my eyes. He opened my eyes. He says, he's a part. That's my brain. Rational explanation. That's a part. Some people will say that about you after you have witnessed to them and delivered the word of God to them. See, the Bible says God sent his word. So he sends it. And you have to go to follow the prescription. If you want to be healed, you got to follow the prescription. Now, whether it's just, go put some dirt and muddy stuff on your eyes and go wash somewhere, follow. Go what he told you to do and follow. Do it. Since you got to be saved, then I got to believe in my heart, say it with my mouth. I got to follow the what? Prescription. If I believe it in my heart, I have to say it with my mouth. You can't say it with your eyes and head nodding. No, you can't. With the mouth, confession. You have to confess with the mouth. Then salvation comes. You got to say what you might want to believe in your heart. You got to follow that prescription. Okay. What happened? I got saved. Tuesday night. Right here. Right. Right. Who was his name? What's his name? Word? I don't know that. But I didn't buy him. I bought what? Jesus. When you can't believe when you buy Jesus, then you go on from there.
But, yeah.
But who was he? Where do you live?
I don't know.
And the lady that I grew up with since a child, and I told her, right, the next day or something like that, are you still a Baptist?
I don't know.
My mom was Jesus, I don't know. So, this is how this means? If they asked about Jesus and delivering the weight of sin, it was lifted off my shoulder. New life.
Yeah.
Everything's new. Everything's better. Are you still a Baptist? That's what I asked. So, we get stuck going in religion and the law and everything else. Salvation.